Thank you, everybody, for coming tonight. This journey that I started was a long time ago from residential school. I was a witness. I was there. There's so many thousand children died there. And I wanted to remember them. There was a lot of things that I lost. My friend spoke to me tonight. But I learned something from that time. When they changed the law for me to go to public school, I went. I walked before it all. My friend, who lived next door, that I grew up with. And he said to me on that day, he said, "Where are you walking down this road?" They said to him, "My dad told me to change the law, that I get to go to school with you, to the same school." To me, that was a big day. It was a change that I didn't have to go through what all those little children had to experience. I was lucky. My dad was an instructor. And so my journey started there. I learned how to carve. I understood the art then. I was 5 years old. I've always been an artist. My dad, my mom, they were very political. They gave me a great understanding of the world. The Native Homemakers Association. They were a great women organization. I learned a lot. My father, from the Union Beast and Chiefs, I traveled with him everywhere. For years, I was trained by my dad. But I grew up and I went to public school and I learned to see Rembrandt, Picasso, Vermeer, Cezanne. I seen the world of art and I enjoyed it. And I think that through time, when I grew older, I became a mass dancer, swathi. I have tradition. I've been a blackface dancer. I've been trained by our people in many ways. The blackface spirit dancers helped me out to teach me the wisdom that I have today. I am grateful that I was initiated as a spirit dancer because it gave me the teaching of to love this world. It's a philosophy of life. Everything is sacred. You have to love everything. And so I learned these things. I spent that time so through time when we're looking at being a young man growing up. There was a few moments that I enjoyed. I enjoyed going to the car to train, the gift that I had. Then the world came to me, and then I asked for help. There's a meaning in the show. Toxicological encroachment of civilization can't be coming to fix. If you look at it, he's ashamed and standing there looking at you. He can feel you, he can understand you. He can fix you. But if you ask him, he says, when I talk to him, Kenny Moses, he said, Yuxweluptun, I can't fix what you're trying to fix, but I can fix your heart. I went to see the attainment because I have a pain in my heart that wouldn't go away. But a sorrowful feeling of watching the planet die. And so I help is, you never know where you get help from. I'm only a human being. I like making art. I've enjoyed talking to the world. I don't want my children to wake up to oil spilled on this coast. I want all of you to come together and stop pipelines coming through these territories. Fish farmers, they have fish lights. There's a painting that a man asked me to do. And so I said, okay, I'll make you this painting. 600 million salmon brought down to 40 million. I think we have something to do in this province. It is time to change the name of British Columbia to our traditional territories of all First Nations. You are not looking after this land. This is our land. We are the protectors. Every Native person born of sovereignty, of being, is the caretaker. It is their responsibility. Don't ask us to sign anything. I want our chief to put down the pen and say, let's make a new deal. Let's share this land fairly. No more use of usurpatory right. I don't need our Aboriginal people to be usurped every day under colonial rule. If we're going to have the United Nations and Canada sign the declaration, then I expect us to live up to it. Protect our people and all of these lands. Our chiefs have a big job to do. And I think that that's very much a responsibility for them as well as other municipalities to share their wisdom together to resolve the things in this province. To have a moratorium on how many logging trucks there are in British Columbia. To have a moratorium on how many fishing vessels are on the water. To slowly eliminate fish farmers. We don't need them. Woo! My work is a visionary of time. I am a symbolist, but I do see a future. You'll see the style that I offer in this world. It's always a question of how are we going to look after this time and place. So, I hope you can understand and see the work. I know that it's going to be upsetting some of the work, but it sometimes is enjoyable too. I'm not always angry. But I do get mad at the world, and when I do, I take my frustrations out on making paintings for the world. So I'm, at this point, I could sit here for 3 hours if I want. Traditionally. But I won't. I want you to enjoy my work, and there's a catalog with all the writers, all the hard work that they've done, and I thank all of them for all the help that I've had on this time. I'd like to thank a lot of people that have helped me in so many ways. Family, and I think that it's important. I think that I can put it in time for you all what it means, how are we going to look after this world. When I was a child, I went to the Okanagan and Vernon on my mother's side. I'm not Okanagan. And I grew up and the birds would wake you up, songbirds. It'd be so loud. When the sun would come up, you would hear these birds. I went back there last year. In my time, I didn't wake up until 9 o'clock. And I got up and I was going, what's wrong? And I went outside. And it was silent. I didn't hear the songbirds anymore. There was very few. So the songbirds are telling us things. That if we don't care for these things, you're not going to hear them. Your children are not going to hear them soon. So I want the world to change so that we can have songbirds.